Hey guys, today we'll show you how to work with overlays. An overlay is another video you place over the footage to blend the two of them. The tricky part is, both files will playback simultaneously in the resulting video and create a unique composition. It's quite a popular technique used to achieve eye-catching effects. For this tutorial, we're going to add a smoke effect to a video. For starters, create a new project and add your footage to the scene. Next, go to any stock video website to download an overlay, or use your own video file if you have one. For instance, we found a nice smoke overlay on video.net. You can check the link in the description. So, you type smoke in the search field, and then set up the filter to only see royalty-free clips. Select the footage you like and download it. Now, edit to the scene and resize if needed. On the timeline, find the blending modes menu and select screen. There you go! A simple overlay-based effect is ready. Now, how about we play with the settings to achieve a more realistic look? Let's add another overlay, resize and drag it to the desired location in the scene. Notice, our original footage isn't still. You can see how the camera is shaking a bit, and the vehicle is slightly moving too. To achieve a more realistic effect, we need to make sure the movements of the vehicle and the smoke motions are synchronized. Sounds challenging? Let's do it! Make a right mouse click on the original video and select Create Movement Map. Then, pick a moving spot on the vehicle that is clearly visible throughout the video and hit Start Analysis. If this is the first time you are working with the motion tracker, the process might look confusing. In that case, check our beginner's guide to using motion tracking in VSDC. Alright, now that the trajectory has been tracked, click Apply Editing. Let's get back to our hyper-realistic smoking effect. Make a right mouse click on it and convert it to sprite. Quickly set up the following parameters. Users container, no. Show effects, yes. Fill background, no. Open the sprite with a double click. See, the smoke overlay footage has a clear borderline at the bottom. So it looks as if the smoke appears from behind an invisible wall. We need to blur the borderline to make it look more natural. To do it, add a rectangle and place it over the footage. Go to the properties and select gradient to fill the background. Click the gradient settings to change the colors and their order. We are going to apply masking, so it should be black and white only. Once you are done, adjust the gradient factor. You want the visible part to remain in the white area and the part that is out of sight to stay in the black area. If you can't see the gradient factor, use the Show Gradient Factor button to make it visible again. After you've finished fine-tuning the gradient, open the Blending Modes menu and select Mask to apply masking. Now go back to the main timeline, find the sprite and apply blending again. This time, select the Screen Mode from the menu. Make a double click on it. If you don't like the way the smoke looks, or if it's barely visible, select the layer with the smoke footage and open the basic effect window to adjust the settings to your taste. It's time to assign the movement path to the smoke. Hit the Add Object icon, proceed to movement, and select movement map. That's it! Enjoy the result! Did you like this tutorial? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe to our channel. Until next time!